Welcome to the Boat Galley Podcast. I'm Carolyn Shearlock, here with tips, reviews, and how-tos for your cruising adventure. The Boat Galley Podcast is sponsored by SeaTech Systems. SeaTech Systems offers cruiser-tested solutions for weather and communications, whether it's satellite, Wi-Fi, cell, or single sideband. SeaTech's packages are simple and affordable. Get free shipping through July 2018 with the code GALLEY2018 at checkout. Slow down. Designing boat systems that everyone can use. Most cruising couples and families end up with each person usually doing the same jobs on the boat. I don't want to call them pink and blue jobs because first, I hate stereotyping jobs, and second, it often has nothing to do with gender, just who prefers to do what. Dave makes the bed 90% of the time. I do 95% of the electrical work. It's not stereotypical, but it's still a division of labor. Some jobs, however, do tend to be assigned by strength or other physical characteristics. Dave is stronger than I am and, perhaps more importantly, taller. He simply has better leverage or the necessary reach for certain tasks. When we began cruising almost 15 years ago, we made a conscious decision that we wanted every single system on the boat to be usable by both of us. I say that we made the decision, but really, it was Dave's background in heavy industry that made him suggest it. In his words, systems have to be designed to be used by anyone. No, it didn't happen immediately, but as we made upgrades and improvement, it was a basic principle that we made sure to follow. When we added an outboard crane, we put extra purchase in the block and tackle so that I could hoist the motor as well as he. We added a low mast up so that I could hook the halyard to the mainsail. I simply couldn't reach it from the deck. Previous owners had installed oversized sheet winches, which made it possible for me to sheet in the sails and furl at Genoa, even when it was windy. Before we bought a 15-horse outboard for the dinghy, we made sure that I could pole start it. On our current boat, we've done the same. We substantially modified our dinghy davits, both to make them sturdier in general, but also so that I can hoist the dinghy with the motor on. We changed the lifting lines to have additional purchase and to automatically cleat when hoisting. Again, we added an outboard crane and once again used more purchase than what Dave alone would have needed. Barefoot Gal came with an electric windlass, but we would have added one had it not. While Dave can hoist our 35-pound Mantis without it, I would have a very difficult time. We have a water maker and use it daily. We both appreciate not having to lug jerry jugs of water. But the reality is that while Dave could transfer 4 or 5 gallon jerrys from the dinghy to Barefoot Gal, I'd have to do it 1 or 2 gallons at a time. We have a siphon hose for filling both diesel and gas tanks, and we have 2 and 2.5 gallon gas cans. I'd have a hard time getting more diesel aboard if I filled the 5 gallon jerrys full, but I can transfer their contents into the tank without a problem. Since the gas cans are smaller, I'd have no problem refilling them and getting them back aboard. And if I really needed more diesel and Dave couldn't help, I could simply fill the larger jerrys, not all the way full. Along with physically making sure we can both do everything on the boat, we also add little notes or cheat sheets. Fill to here, or do this first. On the dinghy davits and outboard crane, lines are marked for all the way up and release to here to hook up positions. When we started cruising, we envisioned that someday one of us could be injured or ill, and the other one essentially having to single-hand the boat. We all think about the horrific possibilities, a heart attack, stroke, man overboard. The reality is that even something like a broken finger can make certain tasks impossible to do. This winter, our prep paid off. Dave had minor surgery. It was an outpatient procedure, but until things heal a bit, he was forbidden to do much of anything other than sit or lie down. No starting the outboard, no starting the generator, no hoisting the dinghy, no filling the water tanks, no climbing out of the cockpit, even to hang up a towel. but all those things still need to be done. And while I may not do his jobs as quickly and easily as Dave does, the fact is, I can do them. It bugged Dave that he couldn't do what he normally does. He fades feeling useless. But I explained to him that he was not useless. He was the one that made sure I could do everything. Until next time, then. Thanks for listening. If you like the show, please be sure to subscribe in your podcast app. Just search for the Boat Galley Podcast. And reviews are always appreciated. Until next time, then.
Slow down, slow down.